In this video, we're going to go over an example design process. The steps that we're going to cover include observing the world around you, brainstorming solutions, comparing ideas, making prototypes to test ideas, and repeating steps all to solve a problem. Welcome to the Product Design Lab. Now here, MIT students will practice product design. In product design, you start off with a problem, and then you design a product or a service that ends up solving that problem. Now engineers will learn as much as they can in order to be effective designers. That way, they can use what they've learned in order to help people. We're going to be going over something like a recipe that'll help teach you more about design. One good place to start is with an observation. Now in an observation, you just pay close attention to the world around you, and you look for any problems that you might be able to solve by designing something. You can pay close attention to things at school, or while walking around outside, or maybe even in your own home. Let's walk through an example so that you can learn a little bit more about how designing works. So I've spent some time looking around at home, at school, and even while playing sports, thinking about different problems that I can solve. And I've encountered many problems, but let me tell you about the one that I want to try to tackle right now. So my favorite sport is volleyball. And when you're by yourself, it's pretty difficult to practice your skills alone. So I wish that there was something that could help you practice when you don't have anybody else around. Now that we have a problem to solve, let's start brainstorming different solutions to that problem. Brainstorming is an incredibly important step in the engineering design process. If you can think of multiple ways to solve a problem, then you have a good chance of finding a really good solution. So let's get to it. I've brainstormed many solutions to this problem, including services that help you find other people to practice with and find a coach to help you practice, but I've also explored devices that will launch a volleyball you can then practice with. Three interesting ideas I came up with include a kicking device to launch a ball, a slingshot device, and a pitching machine volleyball launcher. Now that I've picked an idea that I want to explore further, the next thing an engineer will typically do is make quick prototypes to figure out more details about their solution. Quick prototypes are useful because they don't invest a lot of time or money, and they keep things flexible so that you can explore other solutions as well. What I have here is a prototype made of cardboard that's going to help me explore the kickball volleyball launcher solution. So it's basically just a cardboard structure with a hammer that's going to act as the kicking force for launching the ball up into the air. So after you've made your models, the next important step is to test them out. That way, you can figure out a little bit more about where your project should go. Some important questions that you hope your model will answer are things like, does my idea even work? Do I need to talk to users some more? Is it worthwhile to make a more refined, more expensive, and more time-consuming prototype? Those are the kind of things that you hope a good model will answer. So to test this one out, I've gotten into a room that's got a little bit higher ceilings so we can see what this thing can do.
Here we go.
So even though that was a lot of fun, we actually learned a lot from this prototype, even though it wasn't that expensive or durable. One thing that I noticed is that it's kind of difficult to get the hammer to impart some momentum on the ball and launch it up into the air. Another thing that I noticed is that the ramp kind of has to be designed pretty well. Otherwise, if the ball hits it, it's not going to get launched up into the air. Finally, another thing I noticed about this idea is that by design, it's not really that portable, because it's dependent on lugging around a big heavy weight. So that could be a problem if you want to take this thing out into a volleyball net. Based on the things that I've learned, I've actually decided to switch from a kickball launching method to a slingshot method. Remember how I mentioned that you don't always get it right the first time through. Because this video is a little bit short, I don't have time to go through another model at this level. So we're going to skip ahead to a more refined prototype. Okay, so here's our more refined prototype. It's made of wood, so it's a bit more durable than the last one. And it's going to help us find out a little bit more about the slingshot solution. So the way that this prototype works is that these elastic bands up here will act as the slingshot with these two posts. And this hook is going to connect to a pin that goes through these holes right down here. Then, when the pin gets removed, the ball should get launched from this funnel. So let's see how well it works. So even though this prototype worked, am I done? Absolutely not. There's still a lot more to do. I could do stuff like improve the model by talking to users and see if it actually meets their needs. I can make it a little bit more user-friendly and easier to use. I could add some more features, something like a ball feeder so that you can have multiple balls and then it launches them one at a time. There's still plenty of things to do. Keep in mind that the design process is actually an iterative thing. So you'd go through it over and over again until you arrive at something that's ready to go to market. I hope you learned a bit about the design process and your hope to go out there and design something yourself.
Okay, so let's recap the process we took. We made an observation that it's difficult to practice volleyball by yourself. We brainstormed solutions to that problem, and we compared ideas to pick our favorite one. We made prototypes to test those solutions, and then we had to repeat some of those steps in order to find even better solutions. That's how we came up with a way to solve the problem of it being difficult to practice volleyball on your own.